Hi all, welcome to my channel, welcome to John's Model Making. Today we've got the Mitsubishi Zero Fighter from Agora, Pack 12, yes. Now, this is mainly about the display stand today. Obviously, we'll finish the aircraft on a separate video. There's not much to do on the aircraft. Attach the wings and the pilot. I think there's the upper fuselage panel, the drop tank and the bombs, as well as the cannons. He's got some extenders for the cannons, but we'll do that in a separate video because the display stand we need to just complete. We can test it, see how it's running. If you remember from last month, stage 87, I had a faulty part, and here is that part. Now, that was the problem. That came straight out of the cog. It should be a tight fit. There you go, but obviously that's no good. So Agora did send me a replacement stage 87. That is fitted. It's now in the display stand. Everything is at default state. Well, so I believe anyway. But now we just need to complete the stand and then we can test it. Make sure there's no adjustments needed. But we do need to include the switch, the PCB, let's see, and the battery as well, because this is run off a battery. Now I have got a power supply for that, and here we have the power supply. It's a variable switch power supply. It's set at 5 volts. I have asked Agora what it should be set at. They said anything between 4 and 5 volts, but preferably 5 volts. Then we just need the USB mini USB charger port connector for that, so we can charge up the battery and then we can check the display stand. So without further ado, let's get on with the build. Okay, these are all the parts for issue 93. We've got the screws, we've got a couple of brackets, we've got this switch which fits in here, and we've got this base panel which we can put to one side, because what we do need is a side panel, this particular one with these holes here. Basically this switch will fit into here, and you must make sure we get the terminals the right way around. That's the wrong way around. Fits in through there. Yeah, the terminals on the left hand side of this, and that will just sit in there, hopefully like that. Excellent. And that fits in there. And we'll just pop a couple of screws on. 1, 2. There we go. On, off. Excellent stuff. Okay, we just need a couple of screws. There we go. That's the on-off switch. Now, we need this panel. Okay, this panel, now I've took it out of the paper, slots in there like that, and then this slots. Okay, don't mind my mistake. What we need is this panel from issue 91 and this bracket from issue 89. Basically, the cutout here, the corner joint there, that will fit in nicely here, like that. And then we have the bracket there. There we go, you can see where the bracket goes into that corner, and then we have another bracket from here to here, so we'll get that in place. Now it's 3 of the screws in place. Now this bottom one in, it can be rather confusing keeping all these parts to one side before you use them, and then when you do come to use them, you put in parts in for multiple packs, so it's normally get confused. Right, now we've got this cross piece, this will strengthen this corner up even more so now. There we go. That's that piece in place. There we go. That is stage 93 complete. Excellent. Now we'll move on to stage 95. Okay, doke, stage 95, we have the charging unit circuit board. So let's get the parts out. There we have. Now we do need this part from issue 91. Basically, that sits on there like that. We have two screws, one there, that are in this pack. There we go. There we go. Pop that in there like that. And that is what we have left. That is issue stage 95, I should say, complete. Okay, now we've got stage 96. Let's get the parts out. And there we are. We have another base panel, which just fits nicely there, like that. We have an infrared panel, some more screws, and a plate. We also need this plastic plate, which came off a side cover. Came off here. This was from issue 89. Those are the screws. And basically we need to put the infrared board on that bracket. And we basically want it in this position. So two screws. There we go. Just like that. Now we need to put this back into the side panel that we took it off. There we go. Connect that up there like so. That's back in position though. That's the infrared circuit board. Okay, look, now we need to connect this base panel with this side panel, like so. This is the one with the on-off switch. And this bracket from issue 91 fits there, like that. And now we need to screw that in place. Four screws. There we go. Excellent. Just one more piece along here now, and that will be the bottom completed. Okay, don't know, we've got one more bracket for here. That fits there like that. Another bracket for here. There we go. You can see that in the overhead. And then the charging board will fit just nicely in there like that, and we'll screw all that in place. There we go. Excellent. Sorry about my arm getting in the way. Now we need this bracket here. Excellent, that'll keep that nice and strengthened together. Brilliant stuff. Excellent, there we go, that is that stage complete. Now let's move on. We only have this one side panel here to fit. Brilliant. Stage 97, there we go, that's the battery. We'll just check the battery, get it out of the packaging. There we go. Nothing's split, nothing's bulged. Cable seems to be in good condition. Excellent, that looks fine to me. Let's move on. Here we have stage 98. We have the pilot there on his Todd. We have a side panel and a battery housing with more brackets, and we have two brackets from previous, one from stage 79 and one from stage 93. So we have them to fit, and then we have the battery into the housing. So let's get the parts out. There we go, those are the parts. That's the battery housing and its cover, which will eventually go on there like that with the battery inside it. So pop that to one side. We got the pilot, he's looking brilliant. Let's just get him out of the bag, have a quick look at him. There we go. Nicely detailed. Got that detail on the back there. Excellent stuff. Brilliant. Looking superb. He looked great in the plane. Pop him to one side, and we got a couple of brackets, and we need these two brackets as well to fit this side panel, which goes in here like that. Okie dokie, let's get it all connected up. Okay, now I've repositioned the display stand, because basically this last side panel wasn't squaring up, so I've had to undo most of the screws on these connecting brackets to make sure it's all square, there's no gaps, and squeeze it all together. That would happen because it's the last panel, obviously. You can't always tell as you're going along, but it's now fully tightened up there. All we need to do now is add the brackets. Excellent stuff. So we have four brackets, this corner one here, this cross piece which will go there like that, one here holding these two pieces together, and this one goes here, and that will be to support the boards that cover all the mechanism inside. Excellent. So I'll screw them in, back with you in a minute. Okay, no, those are the four brackets, all attached now, all screwed in, looking brilliant. All we got to do now is the battery compartment, so let's get on with that. Okay, no, here we have the lid, we have a battery and a nut for the lid, and the battery. The battery, basically, there's a hole there for the plug to go through, and we can pull the cable through just like that. And that sits there. We have a screw here and a place there for a nut, as you can see. So pop them in and then we'll pop it in place. There we go, that's the lid in place, one screw and one nut. Now we just need to pop this in the correct position on the display stand. Now here we have the battery. 1, 2, 3, 4 screws. So I'll pop them in place. And the last one. Excellent. Now all we need to do is put the PCB in place and connect all this wiring up. Excellent stuff. Okay, look, now we got stage 99. That's the PCB. We've got to fit that in. 4 screws, which are there in a little bag. 1, 2, 3, 4. There we go, that's the PCB. All I need to do is to screw it down. Like I said before, 4 screws onto these pillars, then we can connect up all the cabling and we can test this functionality of this display stand. That's the PCB in place. Okay, let's connect all these up. Now they are all labeled up. That one is J3, as you can see there. That goes here. Just like that. Then we have Z3, which is at the front here. and we have W, and here we have U. This one is J1. This one is Z1. That's the speaker one. We got here, we have another camera. Now Z2. J2. Nice tight fit, that one. And then we have N. No mistaken, N. For there, now I'll have to dress these as well, these cables. We have anything missing, and we have S for the speakers. That goes there, like that. And this one has a T. Excellent, I think that's all I'm occupied now. Brilliant. Okay, now these cables are connected. Make sure you get the end one is the battery, the middle one is the on-off switch, and that one goes off to the main PCB, which is you. And all that's left to do now is charge that battery up and give it a test. Excellent stuff. Oh, there we go, those are the top panels in place, and something had to go wrong today, didn't it? This panel doesn't fit as it should. There's a gap here. That one is perfect. You can see the hole there, and there's a cutout here, so you can remove it easily enough. I have tried to adjust this lifting device, push it further back, doesn't go any further back. The board underneath won't go any further back. So the only thing I can think is that they've cut this board incorrectly, because it is the perfect width. Well, there you go. So it doesn't sit just a few millimeters out here. Still a gap here. So it looks like about half an inch maybe. So I think I'll have to make this hole bigger, because there's no way on earth I can make any adjustments inside. If you take these six screws out, it will slide back and forth, but I put it for as far back as possible. This won't move any further back, it's just impossible the way it's designed. I've disconnected this and this bracket and these two screws to try and push this bottom panel further back, but it won't go any further back than what it is. So it looks like they've drilled that top panel, or made that hole in that top panel a little bit off center. I've not measured it yet, but anyway, it is charging up now. I have got the adapter connected to it. Let's see if I can show you. There's the adapter, and there's the switch. It's still, the LED is still red. It needs to turn to green before I can actually power it up, but bear with me, back with you in a few minutes. Well, there we go, managed to get it to fit. This hole is here rather than over here, and that is quite a tight fit, but it's still charging up, so I'll have to see how this operates. If it rubs too much, then I'll have to make that hole bigger on that side. Hi all again, here we go, 4 hours of charging this display stand. Now I've took the top panels off, as you can see. I did manage to get this one to fit, but I'm not going to chance it, because I'm going to make the hole bigger for there. But I connected up the adapter, and it literally did take 4 hours to charge the battery up. The little LED goes to green. So finally, just after, what was it, about 20 past 7 at night, it went green. So now we can switch it on, and what will happen is the lifters will rise and then go back to the default state, and then we can use the remote control to check the other functions. We can do the engine start, take off, and we'll see if we'll bank as well. So anyway, here goes. Switch it on. And you got to give it 10 seconds. So at least the lifters are working. I don't think any of that wiring is in the way. So now let's try the engine. We do have a red light here indicating power. Now we'll try takeoff. We'll bank left. Bank right. We'll try the machine guns. And that was the cannon. Obviously we can't try the lights, but we can do the landing. There we go. Engine stopped on its own. And we can switch that off. Excellent. So we know it all works. All we need to do now is put the plane on it, which is brilliant. So that function test is absolutely fantastic. So I'm really chuffed about that. But 4 hours for charging up. Ooh. And I actually did swap chargers. I needn't have, because apparently you can use anything above 10 watt and above 2 amp. So you can't use a phone charger. The first charger I used was rated at 30 watt. I think it was about 2.5 amp or 2.1 amp. And the second one I used was 36 watt, giving 3 amp. Both set at 5 volts. But anyway, that is it. So that is the display stand finished. Obviously this fits on here just like that. And the other one, I did manage to get it to fit. Well, it's a tight fit. There we go. As you can see, it's close up, so I need to make that hole a bit bigger. And the hole is here. We're taking this off rather than over here. But I'm not too fussed about that. So anyway, we did enjoy that. It took a long time to get this together, but it's there now. Now it is very solid. On their website it does state that it's square at 25 inches by 25 inches, but it's not. It's 25 inches wide, 21 inches deep. So that's even better, that, because it's smaller. But all I need to do now is complete the aircraft and we're away. So look forward to that video. Anyway, thanks for watching, stay safe, and if you did like this, give us a big thumbs up, subscribe and hit that notification bell, and I'll see you for the aircraft video soon. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.